Meanwhile, the Philippine power distributor warns consumers of higher electricity rates this month. Meralco says the potential increase is due to an unexpected hike in power prices from the spot market. It says the final figure will be announced Thursday. Meralco also sought to assure customers it will work to mitigate the possible increase in rates. The Philippine Justice Secretary says Interpol has issued a blue notice against embattled lawmaker Arnolfo Teves Jr. Remulla told reporters Wednesday this was how the government was notified of Teves's whereabouts in Timor-Leste. A blue notice allows the Interpol to collect additional information about a person's identity, location, or activities in relation to a criminal probe.
The blue notice is there already, actually. What's happening now is that we are informed of his movements by all jurisdictions. Once he enters a certain jurisdiction, they already inform us of his movements.
Teves is deemed by Remulla as the main mastermind in the killing of Provincial Governor Roel De Gamo. The suspended lawmaker was denied asylum in Timor-Leste, a request that Remulla says had no basis.
Asylum is a term used to seek protection from a state, from persecution. But this is not the case because there is no persecution involved here. What's happening here is that there is prosecution. Timor-Leste did not grant his application for asylum for obvious reasons, that there is no real basis for it. And that Timor-Leste did not want to be involved in our local peace and order problems, knowing fully well that since they have people who are in the country observing our local processes, they know that there is a case developed.
Remulla says the NBI will file murder charges against Teves on Monday.
E-wallet service provider GCash insists there was no hacking involved in the unauthorized fund transfers that affected some of its customers. The funds of hundreds of GCash users were allegedly transferred to accounts in East West Bank and Asia United Bank. GCash did not disclose the total amount affected by the incident, but it says all the funds have already been returned. Based on its initial investigation, GCash said the users unknowingly clicked a phishing link.
Definitely no hacking, because kung meron tong hacking, the impact could have been bigger, no? We are not blaming our customers. Based on our investigation, that we found out that this impacted customer base unknowingly access a phishing link. Ang nakita namin sa investigation, this fraudster, hindi siya nag-action during the time that he was able to phish and mine this information from the customers. No, again, how did we found out na ganito? There is a request to link a device. Yan yung lumabas na investigation natin. And an OTP was sent. And using those information, the fraudster was able to make that transaction.
Two House minority leaders speak out on the GCash fiasco. House Deputy Minority Leader Bernadette Herrera urges GCash officials to divulge the scope of the system glitch and bear plans on preventing similar incidents. Assistant Minority Leader Arlene Brosas amplified Herrera's calls for GCash to strengthen its data protection mechanisms. Brosas dubbed the incident a huge inconvenience for the company's 80 million registered users. She also noted how the SIM Card Registration Act has so far failed to safeguard Filipinos against data hackers. Brosas's Gabriela Women's Party is set to file a resolution calling for an investigation into online scams and what digital banking applications are doing about the problem.